My name is Victoria Papali. I am an artist and I also teach portraiture. Today I'd like to share with you some of my artwork. In a way, we'll travel back into time. You'll see that most of the characters in my paintings are from Greek mythology. You can say that the Greek culture is my muse. A few years ago, I attended the Aegean Center for the Fine Arts in Paros, Greece, and it was there that I was introduced to the beautiful economic palette of the four earth tones, white, black, burnt sienna, and yellow ochre. That was a pivotal point in my career because that really did change how I paint. So without further ado, let's take a look at my first three paintings, a trilogy of Helen of Troy, Homer's Helen of Troy. Here we have Helen's birth, and here's her mother, Queen Leda, and there's Helen just being born from her beautiful golden eggshell. The myth claims that Zeus turned into a swan, mated with her mother, and that's how Helen was born. But here we have her, I like to think of it as a birthing cave. She tried to hide the birth of Helen, trying to protect her, but she really couldn't all the way. I have this as a mystical fire, trying to protect her from Zeus. The herbs in it are thwarting him. And their snake, which is also keeping Zeus away. In the background, I have a beautiful column and temple and sort of surrealistic sky. Okay, the second one is when Helen first sees Paris at Sparta. And this is the pivotal point in her life because this is the first time she laid eyes on the young Trojan prince, Paris. And I have her in a palace. There's a little bit of light from the torch. She has a harp of love, her seven-pointed star, her beautiful blue eyes. Again, I did not use blue. I used the black and white. Mix them, and then we can make our blue. So the little controversy when she first sees Paris, some say she was abducted, and I say, just by the look at her face, that she was a willing participant, leading her family and her Greek husband, Menelaus. So let's look at the beautiful Helen of Troy at a very tragic point in her life when she doesn't have much. This is when Troy is burning. And, you know, after Troy took her, Paris took her to Troy, that started a 10-year battle with Greece and Troy. Finally, the Greeks won. They conquered Troy. This is the fire up top. And here's Menelaus, her Greek husband, who swore he'd kill her once he found her. And beautiful Helen, one thing she has left, she lost everything, is still her beauty. She's very scared. You can tell by the look in her eye. But she is still very defiant with her arm, a little sign of strength. I see her as a survivor. Here she's captured on a Greek boat. And she was right. The only thing she had was her beauty. And once Menelaus saw her beauty, tradition claims he forgave her, and he did bring her back to Greece. So let's look. Here's Dionysus and a nymph. I took the artifact of Dionysus on the boat when the sailors turned into dolphins, and I decorated the palette with it. I took a picture of a beautiful young African-American girl I know in Philadelphia, and I made her the nymph. Tradition claims that he was raised by the nymphs of Nysa, and that's what I made her, one of the nymphs, very pretty, in the four earth tones. Next is Dionysian Festival. This is a Dionysian Festival. Here's old Dionysus, the grapes. But this dancer I did take from a 5th century BC vase. It's the a dancer for Apollo, but I placed her in this. It's a little humor, having a little fun. Dionysus, a flute player, on the earth tones. And in my next painting, I took the stylized version of that dancer, and I made her human. A friend of mine posed for it, and you see she's in the same position. It's very pretty. And she's dancing for Apollo, maybe Telos. Where would we be without the beautiful Athena? Athena, she was the goddess of weaving, of battle, of pottery, and of wisdom. And in this one, the symbol for wisdom was the yale. She had her symbol of the sword. She always had a gorgon on her shield, but I put the gorgon up on her headband. Next, I wanted to show how beautiful the earth tones can make even still life look. Ancient ladies, beautiful fig, orange, and pear. Just lovely. And we have a pretty lilac color from the Earth Tones too. And where would we be without old Apollo himself? He has a beautiful golden laurel leaf. Tradition claims his number was 7. And his symbol was the raven. Very nice. And here we have Mass, Comedy, and Tragedy. I use myself as tragedy. And here we have a youth and old age and a Minoan figure here. This was thought to be the mask of Agamemnon. Not really. The beautiful Cleopatra. I use a young man for her. I think he knew that I used him as my model for Cleopatra, but that's Caesarion. And last but not least, the beautiful Oracle, or the Pythoness of Delphi, breathing her sacred smoke, which inspired her to foretell the future and to advise great kings and princes of the land. So, that's it. I want to thank you for spending a little bit of time with me in my studio. You can see more of my paintings at vpapali.fortunecity.com. Thanks again. If at a stop out of belief, yes.